A year ago today, we released a video called Jesus is Polyamorous.
Jesus is polyamorous. Yeah, you heard me right. Jesus is polyamorous. We know this already though, even if we don't think about it or put it in those terms. In Ephesians 5, Paul specifically uses the word marriage to describe Christ's relationship with us. Repeatedly, Paul reminds us that Jesus gave himself for us. Us, the church, which Paul describes as the whole body of believers.
And the results were kind of bananas. It quickly got over 100,000 views. But more importantly to me was all of the people behind those views. Hearing from you in comments or in shares on Facebook or Twitter or in direct messages or emails about your own journey with polyamory or your own experiences with open relationships or your own like efforts to support your friends who are open or polyamorous was just like really, really cool. But it was also like a really intense few weeks because there was some pretty substantial negative backlash. I got dozens of death threats over the course of those few weeks and hundreds more abusive comments and just like nasty video responses, people telling me that I should be executed, that they should bring back the Inquisition, sending GIFs of electroshock therapy, machine guns, and even like more stuff that is like too trigger-inducing that I won't share here. And so, as I look back on the past year, it's like I have a lot of feelings about it. I think that video was like really important to me and to so many people. I know that when Shay and I started QueerTheology.com 6 years ago, or a little over 6 years ago, there was just like no one talking about Christianity, polyamory in any sort of public way. And over the years, I started to share a little bit more about my own experiences in an open relationship and being polyamorous on like the podcast and in webinars. And every time I mentioned something, like folks would pop up and say like, me too, or this is so exciting to hear someone talking about this. I knew that there was just this like need for this conversation to happen. And it just like wasn't happening. It's like remarkable to think about like everything that has changed in the past year. And so Shay and I decided we were gonna do something about that. So we decided to put together this online course and group program around Christianity and polyamory, both for polyamorous folks and also for single folks that wanted to learn more. Shay used to be celibate and is now in a monogamous relationship, but has shared on the website about how polyamory and his polyamorous friends have like enriched his own faith and his own relationships, and so we knew that this was like gonna be a blessing for everyone. And so as part of that, I made this now infamous Jesus is Polyamorous video. And like I just like can't like wrap my mind around everything that has happened since, you know, like Kevin Garcia has come out as non-monogamous curious. I was asked to present on polyamory at the Q Christian Fellowship Conference for the first time ever. I consulted on like a book for them. I was featured on the Multiamory podcast talking about Christianity and polyamory. Like all these like big things aside, just like the way in which folks are talking about polyamory and open relationships, like on Twitter, in blogs and articles and podcasts in the national media, like there has been this like huge shift in the discourse, and that's just like been super exciting to be a part of. And while I like certainly lost a lot of sleep and had a lot of stress for those weeks when all of the like death threats and abusive comments were rolling in, if I had to go back in time, I would do it all over again because there's just been like so much goodness that has come out of that. We launched this Christianity and Polyamory course and I've gotten to work with over 50 of y'all, like in a more hands-on way, digging into the Hebrew Bible, digging into the Christian scriptures, digging into Christian traditions and the practices of the church, exploring concepts like agape and God and the Trinity, looking at polyamorous and open relationships best practices. We've celebrated births and new relationships and mourned some breakups, and it's just like been like an awesome community coming together inside a Sanctuary Collective and sort of as its own separate Christianity and polyamory thing. And so we're definitely gonna keep on doing that because I think that there's like something really rich here at the intersections of Christianity and polyamory That will be, like, queerness is a blessing to the whole wide world. I think that this, like, intersection of faith and polyamory and spirituality and open relationships has something to teach everyone, not just poly folks, not just Christian folks. And so more is coming. If you want to stay in the loop or be a part of that continuing conversation, I've got two ways for you to do that. So number one, comment below on this video, even if it's just to say, hey, this work is like so scary and being on the front lines and like one of the first people doing this is like super scary. And so I would love to just like meet more and more of you. So say hello and share a little snippet of your open/polyamorous relationship journey. Even if that's just like, hey, I'm poly and Christian too, or like, hey, I'm trying my best to learn more to support my poly friends. I would love to hear from you. And then if you want to stay in the loop as we continue to produce more resources like free stuff and webinars and articles and workbooks and also like paid things like the Christianity and Polyamory course and book, you can either go to queertheology.com/polyamory. I'll put a link to that down below. Or you can DM us on here and I will DM you back. And we can stay in the loop that way. So I guess like happy 1 year anniversary of Jesus is polyamorous. Jesus is still polyamorous. If you haven't seen the video, I will put a link to that down below. And that's all for now. See you later.